Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing solving equations and inequalities graphically. Let's start by solving this equation. The directions say to solve x cubed minus x equals 0. Solution. So to do this problem, what we're going to do is basically put this into our calculator. We're going to graph y equals x cubed minus x. And then we're going to see when is y equal to 0, which is basically solving this equation. So we're going to find the x-intercepts of this graph, and the x-intercepts are going to be the solutions to this equation. Let's go ahead and do it. Okay, let's go ahead and solve the equation x cubed minus x equals 0 using a calculator. So here I have a calculator, and it's a graphing calculator. And so I'm going to go to the place where I enter the function to graph. So I hit y equals. And we're going to enter x cubed minus x. Enter x cubed minus x. And I'm going to hit graph. And that's the graph of x cubed minus x. And we're trying to find out when it's equal to 0. So basically, we're trying to find out when it crosses the x-axis. And if you look here, it doesn't look so good, right? It doesn't look great. What we're going to do is we're going to try to get a better picture. Let me explain something called the window. The window is basically what you see on the screen. So the smallest x value here by default on most calculators is negative 10. The biggest one is 10. The biggest y value is 10. The smallest one is negative 10. So this is usually the default, negative 10 to 10, negative 10 to 10. So let's go to zoom. And zoom in is going to make our window smaller. So essentially, it's going to give us a better picture. I'm going to hit enter. And there we have a better picture. You can also manually adjust the window by clicking window. Let me show you. So you see here's our window. You can adjust the X min and the X max, the Y min and the Y max. I'm going to go back to the graph. And so it's pretty clear from this picture what the answers are, right? We've got negative 1, 0, and 1. So very, very clear. It's not clear. What you can do is you can press trace. Most calculators have a trace feature. And you see we're right on 0, 0. That's one of the answers. Or rather, 0, X equals 0 is one of the answers. And then here, you can't really get the answer, right? It's like an approximation, so like 1.01, so it's probably 1. And then let's go to the other one, which looks like it's negative 1. Yeah, so you can tell it's pretty much negative 1. There is a way to actually find the 0, at least in this particular calculator, and in most graphing calculators. There's something called the 0 command. Let me just show you how to use it really quickly. So it's in the calc menu. And on this calculator, you have to press second in order to access blue keys. So I'm going to press second, then trace. And this gives you all kinds of functions you can use. So I'm going to go to 0 and hit enter. And now we're in the 0 command. Let's find the one over here. Okay. To find the one over here, we need to be to the left of it. So we are to the left of it, but the problem is there's other zeros here. You want to be close to it, but to the left. So I'm going to use my little arrow keys to move my cursor. Okay, so that's good. Our x value is to the left of the x value we're looking for. So I'm going to hit enter one time. Now it says right bound. So we want our x value to the right. I'm going to come over here. Hit enter one time. Hit enter again. And there you can see you get x equals 1. Let's go ahead and find the one over here. Second trace. 0. Left bound. So we want to go way over there, all the way to the left of that particular 0, right? And close to it. Hit enter one time, and then right bound, so we go to the right. Hit enter one time. This older model wants us to guess. Most newer calculators, I don't believe they ask for that. I'm not positive. There we go, x equals negative 1. So you can find all the zeros by using that, or just a visual look at the graph of x cubed minus x. And you get all the answers. So again, the answers in this case were negative 1, 0, and 1. So as you saw, the x-intercepts were x equals negative 1, 0, and 1. I should mention that this particular example is very easy to solve by hand. I'll do it very quickly. If we have x cubed minus x, and that's equal to 0, in this particular case, you can factor out an x. And so you're left with x squared minus 1. Because x times x squared is x cubed, and x times minus 1 is minus x. And this is the super popular difference of squares formula. X squared minus 1 is x minus 1, x plus 1, and that's equal to 0. Then you can see we get three answers here, 0, 1, and negative 1. So in this particular example, the calculator wasn't really that helpful, but hopefully you learned something from what I showed you. Let's do a harder example where the calculator is extremely helpful. Let's do an inequality. Here we have our inequality, which is a much more challenging problem. Question is to solve x squared minus 4x less than or equal to 1. Solution. The most important thing to remember is that you first want to make sure you have 0 over here on the right-hand side. Subtract 1 from both sides. So we get x squared minus 4x minus 1 less than or equal to 0. Now we're going to graph the function y equals x squared minus 4x minus 1. And we want to find the x values for which y is less than or equal to 0. And that is going to be the same thing as solving this inequality. So again, we're going to graph y equals x squared minus 4x minus 1. And we're going to look at the graph and determine when is it less than or equal to 0. Let's go ahead and do that now. Okay, let's solve our inequality using the calculator. So we'll start by pressing y equals, and we'll enter x squared minus 4x minus 1. We want this to be less than or equal to 0. So we're going to look at the graph now and determine where is the graph less than or equal to 0. I'm going to press graph. This is really nice. So we don't really have to make any adjustments here. You can see from the graph, it's going to be less than or equal to 0 from this x value to this x value. And it's equal to 0 at the x values, so you include them to be bracket whatever x value you have here to this x value with another bracket. So you use brackets for your answer because it's less than or equal to 0. To find these x values, you can do it a couple ways. You can hit trace. And so you see this one here is approximately negative 0.2 or so. And then the other one is going to be maybe 4.255 or so. So that's a pretty good answer. You could do better. You could use the zero command. Most calculators have that. Most graphing ones do. In this particular case, it's in the calc menu. So you would hit second first because it's a blue key. So second, then you have to hit this button. And then you go to zero. And then so to find any intercept, it's going to ask you for a left bound and a right bound. Look, let's say we want to find the one it's sitting on right now. So I want to go to the left of it, hit enter, and it says right bound. So you go to the right of it, hit enter again, and there it is. 4.24 is our approximation for our zero. So there's the actual zero there. You want to find the other one? Let's do it really quick. Second trace, go to zero. It says left bound, right? You see where it says left bound? So that means you have to go to the left. So we're going to go over here. Enter. It says right bound now, so you go to the right, hit enter, and then guess, hit enter, and there you have it. So negative 0.24 or so. So the answer would be roughly bracket negative 0.24 comma 4.24 bracket. Really, really cool. So as you saw, our answer is bracket negative 0.24 and then comma 4.24. It's a rough answer, but it's pretty good, and we did it all with the calculator. Hopefully this video has helped you and you've learned some stuff about calculators. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.